Hello there. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am the host, David Pettit, as usual. And today, here in Keystone, Colorado, and kind of ending a whole week of vacation. And just going to end it here, overlooking Lake Dillon. Very beautiful little area through here. And my buddy Vince will be joining me as well. We're going to be looking at this Montecristo cigar. And let me make sure I remember the name of it here, so that I don't get the don't want the wrong name. That's the Montecristo Afrique, and it's a very interesting blend of different tobaccos, mainly from Africa. They got an African Cameroon wrapper, and the filler. We have some Peruvian Lajero leaf and some Tasmanian tobacco in there, and then the actual binder is Ecuadorian Sumatra. So it'll be a very interesting blend, and I'll do like a close-up shot. That'll be on my website or something like that, and I'll get a close-up shot of the actual cigar. I'll just,
since we're not being sponsored by them, we're going to cover them up.
Okay, here we are, both of us now, and we're going to give them a cut, give them a light, and hopefully there's a storm brewing, so hopefully we can get this done before it pours.
And, by the way, thank you for having me on the show again.
Oh, yeah.
Appreciate it.
Favorite little new lighter here. Love this thing.
Nice, because you can actually weld with it. Not really, but it's a nice lighter. Don't want to throw anything away out here. Except stuff that's biodegradable.
There you go, you bet. First taste, there's a little spicy feel to it right at first here. Pretty nice here. Pretty nice. Very woody to me, a woody taste. For me, it's definitely got a little bit of a spice to it. It's not like a huge pepper, just a little bit on the middle part of my tongue anyway. Yeah. What about for you?
I'd agree with that. Explain when you say woody, what does that mean?
For me, woody would be like a taste that I get if I happen to have, like if you stir your coffee with one of those wooden stir sticks, you can taste the wood, like if you've ever, like, to me, the taste of a toothpick, if you're chewing on a toothpick or whatever, you kind of have that wood taste. That's the kind of wood taste that I'm kind of tasting here. And so that's kind of what I'm getting there. And we're back.
Yes.
Edited just a little bit of him having to come over here because he's go through all this shit to get over here, so.
Because I'm not a mountain goat.
Very nice flavor. Trying to see if I get any other different type of a flavor coming out. And right now, still to me very kind of on the woody side.
Mm-hmm.
Not getting really much other than that at the moment anyway. That's still a little bit of spice for me.
How about, not being funny, but what about nut? Do you have any kind of nut? I get just a little bit. Just a sous-sol.
Sideways reference, my fault.
But I just have a little bit of like a nut flavor. Not strong.
Yeah, I would have to Yeah, for me, I guess that there is that little bit of a nut hidden in there. Like, for me, it would be kind of like a walnut or whatever. Mm-hmm. It is leaving my mouth. It's kind of dries my mouth out a little bit. It's burning really nice. Mm-hmm. Can't see the burn line, but it's very thin, very nice, and looks very good. That's nice.
Seems to have a pretty good draw too, doesn't it?
Very good draw. Very good draw. It is made in the Dominican Republic. I did not get a actual price point on it. He ended up getting them through the JR Cigars, and so he got a very good deal on the auction. So the actual price point he paid is not even close to what it's going to be. But they're very, so far, very nice. I wouldn't suspect that they're more than $10 to $12 with the size and all, so that I would definitely. I have a feeling that they're probably more to $7 to $8 range. Maybe that's my guess.
I would agree.
See, I'm pairing it with coffee and just a latte, I guess.
But I would agree with you. I'd say the $7 to $8 range. You were telling me a little bit off camera about how they. Montecristo, this is a fairly new cigar.
Yeah, this one.
So tell me how that works out.
I believe that this one's fairly new. I don't know how long it's been out. I haven't noticed it out that long, and I could be completely wrong. But as far as I know, it's a newer blend, and they kind of put it together from scratch. They didn't use an old blend and then blend more tobacco into that. They just used. This Tanzanian tobacco. They've got that. What did I say? There's also the African Cameroon wrapper, and I don't know how many cigars are out there right now that are using African tobacco. So that's, it seems fairly new. I might be completely wrong. If so, I'll kind of put a little notation on there later on. Somewhat newer, and I'm not sure when this blend exactly came out, but it's definitely, it's new for me. I've never seen it, I've never heard of it, and I'm just now tasting it now, so it's definitely nice. It's definitely a nice little cigar right now.
And like you said, it came from JR Cigar, the auction site. They have their own website too to buy stuff, but their auction site is really good, and honestly, with shipping and everything, the price point was $2.60 per cigar. So I mean, it's worth taking a risk, on a cigar that you don't know, that's such a good deal. So it's a box of 25. So if you get them that cheap with the shipping, you can't go wrong. And I've done really well with Jason JR Cigar in the past.
Yeah, they're definitely decent. You're not gonna get some, if you want to get your boxes that way or whatever, especially to lower the price for yourself and stuff, it's definitely, to me, one of the better places to get them from. Very reputable as far as I know, and very good quality. They come very nicely wrapped up and stuff, so your boxes come in nice and very well humidified, so seems to turn out pretty good.
But I agree with you on the cigar. I think it's, the more and more, when you describe the woody taste, I agree with you. The more and more I kind of thinking about that, it does have that, like a toothpick type, just the aftertaste, which is nice. It's not bitter at all. And then pairing it with a latte, pretty good.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, having a nice coffee really pairs well with this.
Mm-hmm.
Probably like a scotch and those kind of things also. Will be nice. I would also probably go like port and stuff like that. I enjoy port, sweet. It kind of go well with the dryness of the cigar, because not all cigars do it, but this one for me kind of makes my mouth a little bit dry.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, I don't have a problem with that, but that's what it kind of does.
Yeah, it does. You're right. And like Damon says, we're up here in Dillon, and it's absolutely gorgeous up here. It's been kind of, it's been up to 100 degrees in Denver, where I'm from, and where Damon's from, of course, in Arizona, it's been way over 100. But it's been like, what, 70s here?
Yeah, it's been not over 75, I think, the whole time we've been here. So.
Which has really been a nice relaxing break. It's we've done a lot of fishing and just kind of smoking some cigars, drinking some good coffee, and just drinking some great wine. We were going to bring wine out here, but this is kind of like a national forest thing. I don't know what they say about bringing a bottle of wine.
Yeah, plus we have to drive back, or he has to drive back.
Good point. Good point. Yeah. It's okay, officer. We were doing an expose.
The ash holds up really well. I just knocked mine off, but it's burning really nicely. It's not tunneling or anything like that. It's just very, very well-constructed cigar. Montecristo obviously has a very good name, and their construction is always usually really well done. So.
You think so, too. No, I agree, and I'm not, again, the guy was on here last year with you on the show. I don't smoke near the cigars he does as far as the different types, obviously. So it's nice to hear what he's thinking about this one, because our tastes are pretty similar. And nice to gamble on a cigar and be right. But like you say, you don't mind gambling when it's a Monte Cristo or more of a kind of a respect to pay.
Yeah, definitely. Your gamble is, your odds are pretty good when you're dealing with Monte Cristo or those kinds of, you know, cigars have been around for a very long time, very well-known quality, and consistent. So getting something that you've never had, especially at that price, you can't go wrong. If you're an avid cigar smoker, you definitely can't go wrong. Now, if your tastes don't vary very much, and you like just a strong cigar or a light cigar, doing that, you'd probably want to try the cigar somewhere at least once. That way you know.
I'm buying a box.
Yeah. That way you know you can smoke it and don't have a problem with it. We're definitely smoking good though, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, I never mind gambling this because I knew it was a Monte Cristo and this type of deal. But if you, like Daniel was saying, if you've got a kind of a more on narrow focus or on your flavor, like the really sharp flavor or really creamy flavor, you want to kind of stick with whatever brand that is and not probably buy a box or something, you know, hope, so.
Yeah, that's for sure. This, I'm trying to see if we get, like, another flavor going here. It's still pretty consistent with that woody, nutty type taste. Obviously, getting down there a little bit more, so it's just a little bit stronger than it was as mm-hmm. far as a heaviness on my tongue. It's not spicy right now to me, but it is a little bit stronger. Very nice aroma.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Interesting too, at least with my own experience, limited. When I have smaller cigars, I've had a harder time with the draw. This doesn't have any problem with the draw at all. It seems to draw really easy. It doesn't, like, you don't have to suck it really hard to get the draw through, and just it maintains pretty well without having to puff it every 2 seconds, you know?
Yep, definitely. And smaller cigars, at least for me, seem, especially at higher altitude, sometimes affects it. And so they do seem to kind of go out a little bit quicker, but you seem to be maintaining real fine. Definitely great draw. So absolutely, there's nothing wrong with the construction for me of this cigar at all. It's definitely well worth a try. You know, if you see it, it's got that black box. It's very nice. It's called Afrique, I believe, is how it would be.
I don't know if they say Afrique. If it's African, they have the kind of harder tonation on the end, like Africa. So I don't know if it's that or if it's African. I don't know.
Yeah, because it's A-F-R-E-Q-U-E. So, however you say it, that's how it is. It's like it's going to storm pretty soon, so that'll be fine. But it's been a great week up here. It's very enjoyable. It's, being from Colorado, I mean, I still love it here, but I love to visit, so this is, been here almost, it's 10 days, really, and it's beautiful, perfect.
I think coming from Colorado, too, you know certain things that you're accustomed to that you like yep. The mountains, this type of deal. I love Arizona. Like I said, I'm from Denver, and I moved to Arizona when I was doing my doctoral degree. And I loved it out there. The summers kill me, a little bit hot for me. But other than that, I really liked it. And I really believe I will have a place in Arizona sometime. To me, the two differences, the heat and dry of Arizona and the mountains of Colorado, and especially in the summer, and the Christmas crap, it's really nice.
Yeah, it's definitely, everybody loves their different things. Snow is not my favorite, which is actually, I don't like it very much at all. I love it during Christmas time. Other than that, I'm not really a big snow fan. I've skied here and there a long time ago. Never had a great ski experience. It was always froze my ass off type thing. So I've always just loved the nice warm weather. And this kind of weather is perfect. And so that's why I find myself in Arizona.
Look at the ash in that sucker, man.
Yeah, it's perfect. It's, the burn line is very perfect. Very thin line right there. Hardly, it's not a big, fat, black line at all. So it's very nice. Very well worth the money. I probably, for my taste and stuff, I wouldn't pay any more really than, definitely for me, I wouldn't pay any more than $9 for it. Just I think the size.
That makes sense.
But I'd be surprised if it's at that price range. I don't know. Might be more. I don't know. I think that might be, like $7-$8. Being Monte Cristo, it could be a higher. But it's definitely worth it, especially if you want to try something new. Nice little smoke, it really is. Flavor is staying very much the same. Nothing
consistent.
Yeah, nothing. No real big change coming up here. I expect it to get a little bit stronger still as I go down a little bit more. Other than that, I don't see it changing too much. I'll be surprised if it does. If somehow it goes nuts and completely changes or something, I'll put an addendum on there. But I doubt it will.
I like to have a cigar like this as kind of a change-up cigar, too. Yeah, like, I'm an Avo guy. That's my thing. Avo number threes. I like all Avos, but Avo number threes are my deal. But I tell you, this is different enough where I could do it as a change-up and just change the whole palette, and it's kind of nice to be able to do that once in a while.
Yeah, definitely. Especially if you're smoking, kind of around the same cigar most of the time or whatever, and you want something different. Definitely something good to give it a try. If you like trying all kinds of different things, this is definitely give it a try. Without a doubt, it stays with Monte Cristo name as far as being very consistent, very good quality. I wasn't sure what to expect with the African tobacco and all that, all the differences, but very nice, very very good quality, very nice flavor. Pleased.
I am too. How, if it, from beginning to end, what would you time a cigar? What would be the smoking time for the cigar, you think?
I'm guessing for this one, it's really going to kind of depend on the person smoking it. Some people smoke their cigars quick. Some take forever. but probably just a moderate, regular smoking of a cigar. They're just sitting there smoking it, doing nothing else. I'm guessing at least anywhere from 35 to 55 minutes. It's going to be hitting pretty quick. But thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for tuning in every time that you do. Feel free to go to my Facebook page, the Cigar Review TV Facebook page, if you like. Click like. You don't have to, but if you want to, feel free. You go to my site. You can find me on Twitter and tweet each other and tweet the hell out of each other. But thank you very much. I really appreciate anybody who watches comments. Even if you don't like it and you comment, I'm fine with that. Just be respectful if you do. I'm fine with that. Not a problem at all. And enjoy a good cigar. Enjoy your day, and I'll be seeing you soon. See ya.